Once again, welcome back to the classes. Today also we will discuss about India geographical features. In the last few classes we were discussing about location and extent of India, border and neighboring countries of India, political divisions, states and their capitals, etc. And today we will discuss about the physical divisions of India. India, along with its neighboring countries, namely Pakistan, Bangladesh, Bhutan, Nepal, Sri Lanka, and Maldives, is called Indian subcontinent. India, along with its neighboring countries, are called Indian subcontinent because it has the features of a continent. Okay, it has the features of a continent. What are the features we have? A well-defined geographical feature. It is a peninsula, completely isolated from the rest of the continent of Asia by the Yangfold Mountain, Himalaya. Okay, India's vast east-west and north-south extent. What is the east-west extent of India? That is almost 2,933 kilometers, and north-south extent of India is almost 3,214 kilometers. Allow different varieties of physical features. What are the physical features available over the surface of India? Like mountains, plains, deserts, plateaus, etc. Broadly speaking, based on the physical features of India, India is physically divided into five. They are the Himalayas, Northern Plains, Peninsular Plateau, Coastal Regions, and Islands. Let us study in detail about the physical divisions of India. First one, Himalayas. Himalayas include the Pamir mountain ranges in Central Asia, north of India, formed by the junction or knot of Himalayas. Okay, the Himalayas include the Pamir knot. Already in the previous one chapter we have studied about the Pamir knot. It is a junction of mountains. What are the mountains which are spreading out from the Pamir knot? Himalayas, Tian Shan, Karakoram, Kunlun, and Hindu Kush. The Karakoram and the Himalayan form the west northern boundary of India. The northern mountains can be again divided into three. They are Northwest Range, the North Himalayan Range, and the Northeast Himalayas or the Purvanchal Range. Let us study in detail about them. First one, Northwest Range. It is a series of mountain ranges radiating out from the Pamir knot, known as the roof of the world. It is a group of mountains which are radiating out from the Pamir knot and which is known as the roof of the world. The mountain ranges are Hindu Kush towards the southwest, Kunlun towards the east, Karakoram southeast, Ladakh and Satsar running parallel to the Great Northern Wall or Himalayas. Then second one, that is North Himalayan Range or the Northern Arch. The North Himalayan Range runs in the form of an arch from Kashmir in the north to Assam in the east. It is starting from Kashmir in the north and ending in Assam in the east, and the shape of this mountain range is something like an arch. The westernmost limit of northern arch is Nanga Parvat, and the easternmost limit is marked by Namcha Barwa. Okay, westernmost point is Nanga Parvat, and easternmost point is Namcha Barwa. The northern Himalayan range comprises or consists of three distinct parallel ranges. They are Himadri, Lesser Himalayas, and the Shivaliks. The northern Himalayan mountain is consisting of three parallel ranges. What are the names of these three parallel ranges? They are Himadri, Lesser Himalayas, and the Shivalik range. Now let us move to the third point, third division, that is the Northeast Himalayas or the Purvanchal range. The Northeast Himalayas or the Purvanchal range is also a series of hills running through the different states of eastern India, like Arunachal Pradesh, Nagaland, Manipur, Assam, and Mizoram. They consist of three important hills. They are Patkai Bum and Nanga Hills in the north, Miso Hills in the northwest, and Garo, Kashi, and Jaintia Hills in the center. That is the end of today's class. Thank you very much.